Assalamu alaikum, my name is Dr. Mohammed Sarfraz, Associate Professor of Medicine. Today we will discuss about epilepsy. As far as definition of epilepsy is concerned, it is characterized by two or more seizures, unprovoked seizures due to irreversible brain disease. And what are the questions necessary to ask in history taking? Was any warning noted before the spell? If so, what kind of warning occurred? What did the patient do during the spell? Was the patient able to relate to the environment during the spell, and or does the patient have recollection of the spell? How did the patient feel after the spell? How long did it take for the patient to get back to the baseline condition, and how long did the spell last, and how frequent do the spells occur? Are any precipitant associated with the spell? Has the patient shown any response to the therapy for the spell? Is there any history of urinary or fecal input? Are there any history of tongue bite? These are the questions necessary in history taking. As far as physical examination is concerned, the clinical diagnosis of seizure is based on the history obtained from the patient and most importantly the observers. The physical examination helps in the diagnosis of specific epileptic syndrome that causes abnormal findings such as dermatological abnormalities, for example neurocutaneous syndrome such as Schuch Weber syndrome, tuberous sclerosis and other syndrome. In addition, patients who for years have had intractable generalized tonic-clonic seizures are likely to have suffered injuries required. Regarding classification, we divide epilepsy into three types: partial onset seizures, generalized onset seizures, and undifferentiated. And what is the focal onset seizures? Focal onset seizures are further classified as simple focal seizures, complex focal seizures, and secondary generalized tonic-clonic seizures. Simple and complex focal seizures are characterized by an aura warning them of their seizures. The aura itself is a simple focal seizures. The many kind of simple focal seizures include sensory symptoms, motor symptoms, autonomic features, and psychic manifestations. Simple focal seizure may last a few seconds to a few minutes. However, if the due Regarding complex focal seizures, typically begin with behavior arrest and is followed by a staring of gaze, automatism, and postictal confusion. So these are the four characteristic features of complex partial seizures, in which there is behavior arrest, staring, automatism, and postictal confusion, and obviously impairment of conscious level in this. Typical automatism are chewing, lip smacking, mumbling, and fumbling with the hands. Dystonic posturing of the contralateral upper extremity is often seen when a complex partial seizure originates from the mesial temporal lobe. A typical complex focal seizure lasts about 60 to 90 minutes and is followed by brief postictal confusion. However, generalized weakness, asthenia, and fatigue may last for a few days. The postictal confusion and aura are the characteristic features when we encounter with absent seizures to differentiate it from absent seizure, because in absent seizures, aura and postictal confusions are absent. Complex focal seizures are a frontal lobe region, may feature bizarre motor behavior such as bicycling or fencing postures, may have more of a nocturnal occurrence, more prominent motor features than those of complex focal seizures of temporal lobe onsets, may have a fast postictal recovery to baseline and often appearance. Majority of complex focal seizures have an ictal correlate on the EEG. The simple epilepsy, another variety, is just secondary generalized seizures. Secondary generalized seizures often begin with an aura that evolves into a complex focal seizures and then into a generalized tonic seizure. So three stages: one is aura, second is complex focal seizure, and third is generalized tonic-clonic seizures. However, a complex focal seizure may evolve into generalized tonic-clonic seizure without a preceding aura. So two features. And the third one, an aura may evolve into the generalized tonic-clonic seizures without an obvious complex focal seizure. So any pattern can be presented. Generalized onset seizures are classified into six major categories like absent seizures, myoclonic seizures, clonic seizures, tonic seizures, primary generalized tonic-clonic seizures, and atonic seizures. We will discuss these types. Absent seizures are brief episodes of impaired consciousness with no aura or postictal confusions. They typically last less than 20 seconds and are accompanied by few or no automatisms. of the automatism that develop the facial ones are the most common, with repetitive blinking occurring most often. Hyperventilation or photic stimulation frequently precipitates these seizures. A diagnosis of new onset absence seizures in adulthood is not likely in the vast majority of the cases. Adults often have complex focal seizure with relatively minor automatism, but in some patients, absence seizure can go into the adulthood life. The classical ictal EEG correlate of absence seizures consists of 3 Hz generalized spike and slow wave complexes that may be induced by activation during EEG by hyperventilation and sometimes photic stimulation. The absence seizures go into the adulthood lacking these 3 Hz generalized spike. So EEG cannot be classical in case of absence seizures going into the adult life. As far as myoclonic, chronic and tonic seizures are concerned, myoclonic seizure consists of brief arrhythmic jerking motor movements that last less than 1 second and often cluster within a few minutes. If the seizures evolve into rhythmic jerking movements, they are classified as evolving into a chronic seizures. Myoclonus is not always epileptic in origin. It is sometimes seen during sleep and is a normal phenomenon. So EEG consists of fast polyspike and slow wave. The ictal correlate of generalized tonic-clonic seizures consists of generalized bilateral complexes of spikes or polyspikes and slow waves. These epileptiform discharges often have increased amplitude in the frontal regions. Atonic seizures are also called drop attacks. These seizures occur in people with clinical significant neurological abnormalities and consist of brief loss of postural tone. They are typically found along with other clinical manifestations, typically in epileptic syndromes. These often resulting in falls and injuries, and sometimes patients need helmets. The ictal EEG correlate is similar to EEG abnormalities observed in tonic seizure. The main differential diagnosis in this case is from TIA, drop attacks, and syncope or presyncope. There are various epileptic syndromes. There is a long list of epileptic syndromes. I have mentioned some of them: juvenile absence epilepsy, juvenile myoclonic epilepsal, epilepsy with grand mal seizures on awakening, idiopathic or symptomatic infantile spasm, Lennox-Gastaut syndrome, mesial temporal. As far as differential diagnosis is concerned, we have to differentiate with various brain infections like meningitis, encephalitis, meningoencephalitis, cerebral malaria, cerebral abscess, brain tumors, and various metabolic encephalopathies sharing similar clinical features with epilepsy regarding uremic encephalopathy, hepatic encephalopathy, and various psychiatric diseases, for example, manic episodes, agitated depression, panic attacks, schizophrenia and drug withdrawal, and various sleep disorder like narcolepsy and cataplexy should also be differentiated from epilepsy, and also presyncope and syncope, and various metabolic abnormalities like hyponatremia, hypoglycemia, hyperglycemia, hypocalcemia should also be ruled out. As far as investigations, we should have EEG, CT scan and MRE brain, particularly in those patients in which the epilepsy is of adult onset, to rule out brain tumors, MEC scan, that is called as magnetic encephalography, and various tests to rule out metabolic causes of seizure like urea, creatinine, blood sugar, calcium, and drug screening. And treatment, as far as treatment of epilepsy is concerned, we have various drugs like valproate, carbamazepine, topiramate, lamotrigine. Lamotrigine, ethosuximide, gabapentin, lacosamide, and levetiracetam. The 4 important aspects regarding treatment of epilepsy is when to start the drug, what is the choice of the drug, when we have to add on therapy, and what is the sequence of withdrawal of drugs. So usually after first wave, no drug is started. The main aim of treatment of epilepsy is its free period and minimum side effect. Usually we have to start with single drug, but after first seizure we should not give drug. If there is two seizure or more than two seizure, we have to start drug therapy. But in certain conditions like status epilepticus, in case of family history, in case of fits with neurological finding, in case of head trauma, brain infections, brain tumor, we have to start anti-epileptic drug with first fit. So what are the choice of drugs? Sodium valproate is for generalized epilepsy, carbamazepine for focal epilepsy, and add-on therapy we have to add other drugs like topiramate, lamotrigine, and lacosamide can be given. And usually first, when first drug is given, it increases in dose to the maximum. Then if the fits are not controlled, then to add on second drug. And if the patient is fit free for 1 to 2 years, then we have to slowly decrease that drug one by one as well. Regarding headache, a brief description is of two types: primary headaches, including migraine, tension type headaches, trigeminal, autonomic, cephalalgias, other primary headache disorders. The secondary headaches attributed to trauma or injury, attributed to cranial cervical vascular disorder, attributed to non-vascular intracranial disorder, attributed to a substance or its withdrawal, due to infections, due to disorder of homeostasis. Headache or facial pain attributed to disorder of cranium, neck, eyes, ears, nose, sinuses, teeth, mouth, or other facial or cranial structures, and headaches attributed to psychiatric disorders. Painful cranial neuropathies, other facial pain, and other headaches. Painful cranial neuropathies and other facial pain and other headache. As far as pathophysiology is concerned, the brain itself is not sensitive to pain because it lacks pain receptors. However, several areas of the head and neck do have pain receptors and can thus sense pain. These include the extracranial arteries, middle meningeal arteries, large veins, venous sinuses, cranial and spinal nerves, head and neck muscles, meninges, fox cerebri, parts of brainstem, eyes, ears, teeth, and lining of the mouth. Pile arteries rather than pile veins are responsible for pain. These are certain red flag signs. If present, we have to rule out the important diseases. The American Headache Society recommends using SS-NOOP as a mnemonic to remember the red flags for identifying a secondary headache. For example, if there are systemic symptoms like fever or weight loss, systemic diseases like Regarding treatment, we have different options: NSAIDs, morphine derivatives, triptan can be used in case of cluster headache and migraine. Flunarizine usually used in migraine, propranolol can be used, and various anti-epileptic drugs, carbamazepine can be used, and sedatives, and obviously to treat underlying. Thank you very much.